Here, I am Fiam Gowdar. Today, we have to discuss BSc Fifth Sem Physics Paper 2. In that, unit number 1, Quantum Mechanics. Okay. In that, Quantum Mechanics. First, we have to know about the meaning of the Quantum Mechanics. What mean by Quantum Mechanics? Okay. The Quantum Mechanics name itself. The quantum means the very small particles. Here you are very small particles like atom and subatom. Okay, in the mechanics, what mean by mechanics? Okay, generally you know that we have to study about the motion of the particle. Mechanics means we have to study about the motion of particles. Okay. Exactly, quantum mechanics means we have to study about the microscopic particles. Okay, study about the means the motion of the microscopic particles. Here, microscopic particles nothing but atom and subatoms. In the atom, all of you know that. Okay, subatoms are, if consider the atom and the middle, you have to take the nucleus. Okay, surround the nucleus, electrons are revolving. And these electrons, and in that nucleus, the two parts are present, protons and neutrons. Okay, so these proton, neutron, and electrons, these three are the subatomic particles here. Okay, and study about the motion of these subatomic particles and total atomic particles. Okay, means very tiny, you have to study about the very tiny or small particles. Okay, so before the quantum mechanics, first the two theory are proposed. First one is the Newtonian mechanics and second one is the classical mechanics. Okay, so the classical mechanics, mainly we have to study about the macroscopic particles. Macroscopic means the observable particles. That microscopic particles explained by the classical theory, but that classical theory failed to explain the microscopic particles, means small particles, atomic or subatomic particles. And later that what happens, the idea of quantum mechanics was created, means it takes a birth as a quantum mechanics. In that quantum mechanics, we have to mainly study about the microscopic particles. Okay, so this quantum mechanics initially first discovered by the Max Planck. It was discovered by the Max Planck in 1900. Okay, so this Planck's proposed by theory called quantum theory. Planck's proposed by the theory quantum theory, and this explains about emission and absorption of black body radiations. Okay, is not continuous energy, it is a discrete energy. Okay, in that black body radiation, emission and absorption will be takes place. Okay, this process is not continuous, it process is the discrete means is not continuous, means it is in the form of small packet of energies. Okay, in the form of packet of energy. Okay, in the form of packet of energy, you have to also call it as a quanta. Quanta means also you have to call it as a small packets of energy. Called it as a quanta. Okay, so the small packets of energy having the energy E equal to H nu. Okay, H is here Planck's constant and nu is the value. H is the Planck's constant and nu is the frequency, radiation frequency. Radiation,
radiation frequency.
Okay, the concept also used by Einstein. This quantum mechanics, the concept also used by the Einstein in the photoelectric effect. Okay, in that quantum mechanics later we have to discuss about the quantum effect. In the quantum mechanics, in that next concept is the Compton effect. Okay, so this Compton effect mainly based on the principle of scattering. Okay, so what mean by scattering? Already you know that meaning of the scattering. If you generally consider a ray of light will be incident on any material and the ray of light changes its direction. Okay, that is to say the scattering. Okay, also you have to take a photon is collided with the another photon, the initial photon changes its direction. Okay, this is also a scattering. Here, what mean by Compton effect? Okay, so the Compton effect, this theory generally the proposed by the scientist Compton. Okay, when a certain frequency of X-ray will be incident on a material which is having the low atomic number like carbon, and after the collision the photon will suffer with the frequency, and the due to that suffering the change in the wavelength takes place because the loss of energy, and these total elastic interaction we have to known as a Compton. How it will be here you have to see, you will get clearly. When you are taking a photon, that photon is nothing but an X-ray. Okay, X-ray of a photon is incident ray you have to take. So this incident photon having the energy H equal to E equal to H nu. Okay, H is the Planck's constant and nu is the, you know that, radiation frequency, and the momentum is equal to h nu divided by c because it moves with the speed of velocity. Okay, when this incident photon will be incident on the material which is having the low atomic number, this material having the low atomic number, for example you have to take a carbon, the carbon having the 6 atomic number. Okay, so when the photon is incident on this material, at that time this incident photon will be suffered with the frequency. Why it will be suffered? Why? The wavelength of this light will be changed. If you consider an atom, so surrounding this atom the electrons are divided. When the photon will be incident on this atom, at that time the outermost electron gets the energy from this photon. So outermost electron gets the energy from this photon. So at that time this electron will be scattered here, electron will be scattered on this direction, and this incident photon suffered and it will be changed its direction. Electron will be moving on this direction and photon will be moving on this direction. That is here. The photon will be moving on this direction. Okay, this scattered photon suffered and another change in wavelength is takes place, as well as the energy also changes because the loss of energy is takes place because some amount of this photon energy transferred to the electron. So that's why your loss of energy will be takes place. So due to loss of energy, scattered photon having the E dash equal to h nu dash energy, and its momentum is equal to h nu dash divided by c. And here the electron, due to the collision, electron will be scattered. This electron we have called it as a recoil electron. So the recoil electron having the energy m c square. Okay. So the recoil electron having the momentum m v. Initially, this electron having the momentum m naught phi. So take a m naught phi. Okay, this is the total Compton effect. Generally, what meant by Compton effect? When you incident a certain frequency of a X-ray on a material which is having a low atomic number, and after that this photon suffer with a frequency due to suffering the change in wavelength. The change in wavelength is takes place and loss due to the loss of energy. And why loss of energy? Because the electron takes a certain energy to scatter. Okay, this whole process will be takes place with the elastic interaction. Okay, this is the Compton effect. This Compton effect also have a derivation. We are finding the change in the wavelength of this scattered photon. Okay, we have to find the change in the wavelength of scattered photon. Change in the wavelength, we have to take d lambda. Okay.